Yeah, you know what time it is. We live. Live. Convenient goodies. We waiting on Russell Stamper. We in the building, though. You know what I'm saying? I'm finna get you to this mix, and then we'll be right back.
You know, I think that you got the wrong impression about me. I think in all fairness, I should explain to you exactly what it is that I do. For instance, tomorrow morning I'll get up nice and early, take a walk down over to the bank and walk in and see you. And if you don't have my money for me, I'll crack your fucking head wide open in front of everybody in the bank. And just about the time that I'm coming out of jail, hopefully, you'll be coming out of your coma. And guess what? I'll split your fucking head open again. Because I'm fucking stupid. I don't give a fuck about jail. That's my business. That's what I do.
I say OG's in the house. I say OG's in the house. Ooh, ah, ooh, ah, in your mind.
Who's that knocking on my door? Ooh, it's Mr. Dance Floor.
Ooh, Mr. Dance Floor. Ooh, Mr. Dance Floor.
You niggas are crazy.
Ooh, Pepe. Pepe.
Nigga, sorry, you should know. A kind of chick can never be alone. Yeah. Nigga, sorry, you should know. It's all so fully lit psycho. I turn the side piece to a nine piece.
Menage a trois, double trouble.
Good God.
She's so fine. She gon' make a nigga spoiler. Just to keep her on sight. I just wanna taste the water. Let's stay hydrated. Girl, I got a main thing at the house. Tell me, can you stay down?
What's good? This Grind Hard CT, and I'm checking in with OG Gotti. 414, let's get it.
Ah, Mr. Dance Floor. Ooh, Mr. Dance Floor.
I got racks on racks, checks. $100 flex, 2050s next. I've been thumbing through a check. Racks on racks, checks. $100 flex, 2050s next. I've been thumbing through a check.
100, that's the protocol. I asked Drew, I asked Ben, they never heard of y'all. Since I'm serving straight, drop, they waiting for the fall. I'm gonna hit you when I need to, just wait for the call. My bitch be bitching about that cola, she don't like the scent. Try and argue with a G, I told her fight the rent. 5%, like we had a number and 10. Nigga trying to straight me out, boy, I'm beyond bent. And I'm so, I can't hear you, and so loco, I can't feel you. If that money near you, I might disappear you. All about a dollar, hard knock scholar. Tipsy off tequila, Camarino in my body. I'm a wise owl nigga, real niggas been knowing. With my uptown nigga, all he knows been doing. Put me under public work, cause that money been flowing. Got your bitch on GPS, she on my CVT and flowing. I got
racks on racks, checks, $100 flex, 25th is next. I be thumbing through a check. Racks on racks, checks, $100 flex, 25th is next. I be thumbing through a check. I be thumbing through it. Somebody gotta do it. I be thumbing through it. Somebody gotta do it. Racks on racks, checks, $100 flex, 25th is next. I be thumbing through a check.
I got this motherfucking money, dawg. I got ass right in front of y'all. I blow this glass right in front of y'all. Then whoop our ass right in front of y'all. OG, I'll flip a bitch. Get outside, not bitch, and give me your money, I'm cigarettes. You too, fuck nigga, what the fuck you hoe niggas looking at? Left them broke niggas being broken, goddamn if I'm looking back. Came back with a 38 and 9 ounces of candle wax. Shit, now it's real dope, and I'm everywhere where them cameras at. Father builder, keep hammers, prostitutes and scheme scammers, gold killers, air busters, dope dealers and flim flammers. I sell boy and pimp girls, punk bitch, this my world. I'ma get a mink and buy a lac and take it back to the pimp girl.
Take it back to the pimp girl.
Nigga, take it back to the pimp girl. Diamond speakers are junkies ass, and they unwrap that tin girl.
God damn,
racks on racks, checks, $100 flex, 25th is next. I be thumbing through a check. Racks on racks, checks, $100 flex, 25th is next. I be thumbing through a check. I be thumbing through it.
Superstar J. I
am.
Niggas
take
it. Superstar J. Raven Queen.
They don't make these in the States.
That's a rookie.
Green face roll, I spin 100K. 40 mil a block, 40 on my waist. A bunch of killers, dope dealers on the chase. Fuckin' snitches, cause I'm still pushing weight. I'm getting it in, and I came from off the crate. Let's eat again, we done already ate. Fuck the snakes, brought them over in a race.
Representing Riverside Class of 2019. You're tuning into OG Gotti on hashtag The Gotti Show.
Nigga, I'm rich as a bitch. Ain't no sense in my line. I got a 700 bins and I ain't with Bubba Lins. Can't do this nigga shit.
Two times and I dismiss her. Chillin' Seppi's on. pulling on zip.
I'm cool on that bitch. AC running around dumping BNG coke factory. When it's cost as much you rob factory. Little niggas ain't no factory. They scared to go rack a rack with me. Hit him in his neck, Draco make his shoulders clap. Hop in my trap, even got band holders in the back. This is more than a rap, I really trap. Who the fuck been in my kitchen? I only got blenders, Pyrex, ain't no dishes. Smack the 100 G's out this kitchen. God is my witness, smack the dogs with the fleas. Watch how I mix it. Seppi's bar, man, G, she like the way I kick it. In the kitchen with these potions, I can get so wicked. 180 Honda Dash, I really tip it. If the pussy real good, I really tip it. If it ain't real, act my nigga, I can't really sip it. For a good price, I flip it. That's your business. Hit it with a this or that. That's your mixture. Hit a bitch one or two times and I dismiss her. Chillin' Seppi's on, pullin' on zippers. Got you pulled in the blender. Boy, that's your business. Hit it with a this or that. That's your mixture. Hit a bitch one or two times and I dismiss her. Chillin' Seppi's on, pullin' on zippers.
Plugs in the pants from out of town and then I back him up. Bow heads ballin' out of bounds. We finna pass him up. Boy, been ballin' for a while, I think our time's done. I'm blown up for 30 and yo bitch, I'm fucking up her guts. Rhyme with that heater in them grits, but I don't give a fuck. Find out I'm rhyme with your bitch, gon' have your feelings hurt. You worry about this and me, you should be this for her. She might got your baby, bro, but don't forget I hit her first.
Relax for shit, I got them grams up. Chopper with the legs, it's gon' chase. Some little nigga, these more jealous, these don't lace up. Yeah, bitch, this our summer, y'all gon' hate us. 30s that's your face, now don't play them. Got a legend bust all up on her lace front. Drop your mans in this bitch, leave them taped up. Baseline in the coupe, ain't no chasing us.
What you put in that blender? Boy, that's your business. Hit it with a this or that, that's your mixture. Hit a bitch one or two times and I dismiss her. Chillin' Seppi's on, pullin' on zippers. What you put in that blender? Boy, that's your business. Hit it with a this or that, that's your mixture. Hit a bitch one or two times and I dismiss her. Chillin' Seppi's on, pullin' on zippers.
Yo, this the homie Bizzle McLeod, and I'm always tuned in to Uptown Radio, Trudy.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
DJ Steph Floss was pop.
What you get, you going to
hard. In New York, I did in my socks, running from a up, and I shoot at up. What? And I'm on the block. What? 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 And I'm on the block. In New York, I'm in New York, hiding in my socks. What? Hiding in my socks. What? Selling every rock. What? Shooting at the ops.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
Shooting at the ops. Cause I run that block. Give me top, top. In my drop, top. I did hug on flop, flop, flop. When I drop, drop. I did hug on flop, flop, flop. When I drop, drop. I did hug on flop, flop, flop. When I drop, drop.
Man, OG got you snapping.
Woof, 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 woof. I did hug on cat. I did hug on bad. Fucking on your bitch. I'm her dad. All these niggas sound like cat. What? I'm a soldier. What? Damn, I thought I told you. What? Shooting like a soldier. What? Like I'm from that northern. What? All these niggas. What? Always bold. What?
Hard they flap, whoa. And all these bitches
bitch keep me in the loop. She blow me like a high camera suit. My waters come out like a troop. Innocent boss in the oop. Enjoying my pen up to fruits. I'm in a pen of a coop. Passing you up like you. Turn your head like a screw. Get that hoe a tip. Enough to buy a whip. Get that hoe some zip. She fall asleep, I dip. Rich, bitch. Money, Mitch. What's in that bag? 14 bricks. You got 14 bricks in that bag? Used to drop a Mozzie. Used to be locked up.
Knocking
on my door. Ooh,
it's Mr. Dance Floor.
Juan, what's up? This your boy, Manny Fresh, kicking it with DJ Hector. You heard?
That's my DJ. Go DJ. That's my DJ. Don't you bring no weapons, knives, and guns. Go DJ. That's my DJ. Go DJ. That's my DJ. Go
DJ.
That's my DJ. Don't you bring no weapons, knives and guns. Go DJ, that's my DJ.
What you got, you
boy? In the club, everything I steal. Mouthpiece on shine, outfit on kill. But still, I proceed to make my way to the back, because I heard that's where all the happenings at. I say, hey DJ, will you play that song? Cause I heard it's gonna make the ladies show they thong. Tryna have a little clean fun, bucking and wildin'.
Drake's on the house.
It gotta be Long Island, trying to compose myself. But the music brought it, I be representing the mouth. We got two turntables and a microphone. Ain't nobody going home till the DJ's gone. 1200s is the weapons, wallflowers not allowed. You gotta keep a little pep in your stepping. You can holler for your hood, turn the music up loud. We all different, but it's still all good. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Don't you bring no weapons, knives and guns. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ,
soldier, bring no weapons, knives and guns. Go DJ, that's my DJ. The party's going down and the women is crunk. My DJ in the back, bumping nothing but funk. I'm smoked out in the front, but I'm feeling the beat. DJ, DJ, make them twerk.
Man, oh, DJ, you snapping.
Off the chain, he cut the record like a nigga be cutting cocaine. Slow it down, speed it up, it's whatever you like. Got my DJ on the tables and he's keeping it hype. He got him showing it on, he got him taking it off. He got the moves, booty popping, acting a dog. So just pluck your fingers and move to this. It's getting funky in this bitch, cause my DJ's a shit. Shake a breast, shake a leg, shake your ass or something. Give him props, stop stunting, boo, it ain't about nothing. Catch the wall, catch the flow, baby, catch the cut. It's my DJ on the wheel and he's ripping it up. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Don't you bring no weapons, knives and guns. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Don't you bring no weapons, knives and guns. Go DJ, knives and guns, and the music sound better if you're smoking a blunt. Now make them wiggle, wiggle, and make them jiggle, jiggle. Get the cut and the scratch, and you might just make them twerk a little. All I need is some hen and some uptown weed. My DJ in the back, supplying the beat, some nice sound. Everybody's coming round the day so they can shake their ass to what my DJ play. Don't start no shit, won't be no shit. Dumb bitch, waste a drink on my brand new fit. But I ain't mad at you, baby, cause a pimp don't cry. And besides that, a nigga still look so fly. Go DJ, do your thing, whoa. Make them wobble fast, now make them pop slow. You got them pussy popping, you got them booty popping. You got my niggas buck, now get your hands up. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Don't you bring no weapons, knives and guns. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Don't you bring no weapons, knives and guns. Go DJ, that's my DJ.
I can brag now. I just cashed out, fuck this Louis bag now. Pants fit down sag now, sure they like it when I spazz out. Diddy, I'm bringing cash out, got a big piece for the pass now. No more foreign shit, just bought a spaceship on the blast out, yeah.
I said I'm back down, bro, niggas get a cast out. Niggas know I might lash out, just bring a weed if I pass out. Just give me head, no sass now, I don't wanna be a rass now. Diamonds dancing all on my neck, they choking me, I might tap out. Be ready and go, I'm taking top for all I know. Told her that my feelings died right now, she fucking a ghost. What's my inspiration for all the shit that I wrote? I told them time fly fast, but I don't want my time to fly coach. I just gotta stay patient like a 3-5, I face it. Just like old times, I'm 76, I'm in the basement. Life's what you make it, it won't be shit if I don't make it. Life's what you make it, it won't be shit if I don't make it.
I just cashed out, bought bitch Louis bag now. Pants fit down sag now, sure they like it when I spazz out. BDM I'm bringing cash out, got a big piece for the past now. No more foreign shit, just bought a spaceship, about to blast out, yeah. I just cashed out, bought bitch Louis bag now. Pants fit down sag now, sure they like it when I spazz out. BDM I'm bringing cash out, got a big piece for the past now. No more foreign shit, just bought a spaceship, about to blast out, yeah.
I just realized that. Yeah, check. Come on, man. Go. Ready? Live? All right. You know what time it is. It's the Gotti Show live with Miss K.
Hey, what up, everybody?
Yeah, you know what time it is. Now, we were supposed to have Alderman Russell Stamper in here, but his lousy, and no, I'm just playing, you know what I'm saying, but he canceled. He gonna come back next time, you know, so we gonna catch him next time. Man, don't say I was lying or nothing like that. I got a witness. I showed
it. Very true.
So, you know what time it is. Right. Now, while we got some peoples in here, we like to interact with the people. Hey, they talking about R. Kelly. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying ain't, I don't see nothing wrong with what he doing. I don't even see why it's an issue.
What are you doing?
You don't know what he doing?
I heard.
They said he got a bunch of girls. That you heard about it? He got a bunch of girls in the house. Now, one daddy came out. He had a girl named Jocelyn. And the daddy came out and said that, come over here so they can see y'all, man.
Hey, we just came from the lake. We look great.
Oh, man, come on, look good, man. We black folks always look good,
hey,
man.
Hey, y'all, you know, we just
that's how you're supposed
lake.
To look when you come from the lake. You know what I'm saying? Out there building sand castles, you know what I'm saying? With the children, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, so, yeah, they say he got a bunch of girls in the house, and first they said, they lied and said he was holding them against their will. So, because the daddy came out and held a big press conference. You know what I'm saying? And so, now look, when the one girl, it was a chick that say she lived in the house with him, when she spoke, that's what gave it away for me.
Right.
Because she was like, they obsessed with the thought of being with R. Kelly. So I'm like, they on their own.
Right.
If they can open the door, this is my feelings on it. If you can open the door, then you ain't being held hostage.
Right. Exactly.
And whatever you doing in there, you doing.
Right. That's what you want to do. You're
right.
Wrong.
If I'm in the house with you and you say go sit over there in the corner.
Right.
And I go sit in the corner. You know what I'm saying? Bad. Who is that
and
to say she
open.
Treating me bad?
Right.
Yeah, and I can leave. Yeah, I can leave. Every time she letting me know, you can leave if you want. But you a big star. I want to be with you. Everybody want to be with you. I'm like, nah, I'm going to stay.
Right.
You know, small price to pay. You know what I'm saying? Some girls want to get on.
So the daddy's saying some bull.
Yeah, the daddy came out. And then
I think they just nosy as hell. And they daughter doing what she want to do. She grown.
Mm-hmm.
She don't want to be in college. She want to
A lady. She lady thing and want some
R. Kelly. That's
right.
Her.
Right. She got with the R. That man can sing. You know what I'm saying? He's saying to you, I might go over his house too. He start man, he hypnotizing him with
my
the voice.
Say, you know.
Right. I ain't gonna give him nothing. I ain't gonna be in there on nothing.
My mind
just
is telling me, oh,
right now, this is what I said when Hugh Hefner did it. It was thumbs up.
Right.
He was marrying 17-year-olds. Now, who knows how old all them girls was? He had a mansion full of them.
Right.
Let me tell you how perverted and disgusting he is. He didn't even wear clothes. He stayed in a robe and pajamas, letting you know what time it was. It was party time at any time. He's 70. And there was a 17-year-old. You know what I'm saying?
Made
all the magazines and everything.
Right. Now, they stayed. All them girls stayed up in there.
Yeah.
Who knows what they had to do to stay.
Right.
You know what I mean? I mean, that's just real, man.
Remember the cat house?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, that was...
Yeah. Yeah, and they got...
I was young.
They got the bunny ranch down
in
Vegas. You know what I'm saying?
Boy,
legal pimping going on.
Right, legal pimping. And they talking about R. Kelly. Why are they trying to crush R. Kelly? Right, why are they trying to crush the R, man? Why are they trying to take that man down? Did he tweet something we don't know about?
I thought it was because he had an album coming out or something. That's what my question was.
Oh, and they hyping it up.
Right.
Everybody want to hear about the hostage story. Like,
yeah,
he going to be trapped in the closet. Huh?
Oh, Usher, man. Lord.
They said, now, fill me in on that, because I'm got bits and pieces.
They said he paid a girl, his ex-wife, friend, $1.1 million hush money, pretty much, because he gave her herpes.
Hey, dude, that's crazy, dude. If I gave you herpes, I gave you herpes. You did what you did. Ain't no, I ain't giving you no $1.1 million to be quiet.
Wait, he gave her herpes?
Yeah, that's and gave her $1.1 million to shut the fuck up, and she didn't fall through with it.
Hey, I think they're trying to have watch R. Kelly and Usher. I think it's a cover.
Yeah.
So they can slide. They try to do that on.
They trying to, just like with all this other bull that's going on.
Hey.
Watch our camera and not worry about what's going on in the world.
Yeah.
Now look, because we easily distracted. You know what I'm saying? We go from, you know what made you like that? TV.
Yeah. Program.
That's what made your attention span short and everything. You know what I mean? You like this. You need something else. Then they let you flip through the channels.
Right.
So you can't focus on one thing. You know what I'm saying? So when something come important, that always happens. It be something serious. I report all the news.
Mm-hmm.
I be reporting stuff, and I can report they just put something in the water, and they just did that, and it'll get 2 likes. Then I can post R. Kelly got girls hit in the house, and it'll get 50 shares.
Yeah.
And you know, that's all they care about. They got them. You know what I'm saying? Now Usher, the girl came out and said that Usher.
Yeah, she came out.
And but she signed an NDA, non-disclosure agreement.
No, that's the thing. You I got, don't know.
Hey, you got to have anybody that's you, everybody, you going in business, you going in entertainment or whatever, you could do it. Now have people sign them agreements. Look here, what's going to go on, you don't say nothing about it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Into some weird shit, so you know what I'm saying? Don't talk about it. They say Justin Bieber notorious for them. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You can't come up in here.
Yeah.
You know, simple as that. Yeah, you can't come. Ain't nothing you can do. You can't go tell nobody they won't let me in if I won't sign this paper. You know what I'm saying? Because you got to protect yourself. By then, man, herpes, he would have to give me $1 million every year.
Man,
because you can't get rid of that. You know what I'm saying? That's for life. No. That's probably what somebody she told somebody.
Yep.
They was like, girl, what? Because if she would have told me, I'd be like, bitch, what?
Give me 500.
Herpes?
Give me
You know, hey, I'd have to show her a picture of him. Look, that's what your shit for the look like.
Man.
You better get $1.8 million a year.
Yeah.
For the rest of your life. For every time you have to look at a herpes. You know what I'm saying? That is, Usher, I believe it. These people go around. Remember, Usher been Let young coming up. You know, think if you 14, you got a number one record. Grown women is throwing it to you.
Right.
This man live in Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? They throwing it to you. You ain't thinking nothing about nothing.
Right.
And of course, a groupie is not going to say maybe you should wear a condom. Mm-hmm. That ain't going to happen. Because if she get pregnant, she got Usher's baby. You know what I'm saying? It's a win all around. Except for the herpes. Didn't count on them herpes, did you? You know what I'm saying?
You should have learned this lesson when you cheated on Chili. She made a whole album about her,
right,
and then turned around and then got herpes. What's wrong with the man?
I know Chili over there like, wait a minute, Chili, you got herpes? We need to go get Chili checked.
Hey, they made a joke like TLC little.
Hey, we need to go get Chili checked. Is there ain't Usher snacks you eating over there?
Oh, hell no. Hey,
they got the Usher. Don't eat them Ushers.
Usher snacks.
Your whole mouth gonna break out. Everything.
Right.
Oh, no telling what you get with Usher. Come on, nasty. Man, I could believe it. They be on the road. They ain't thinking about nothing. But see, he was young. Usher probably had herpes since he been about 13.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
He knew it.
He knew it at some point. It flared up on him.
Right.
At some point, he was like, what is this? He like, I ain't going to tell
That's
nobody.
Bad.
He can't tell nobody.
Put out there like that.
That was cold-blooded.
After you paid all that much for hush money.
That was cold-blooded.
Yeah.
She did not have to do Usher like that.
But you know, everybody's selling stories now. That's the thing.
Anybody could, that's what the daddy and them doing with the R. Kelly shit.
Right.
They come out, somebody want to interview him, we'll give you $10,000. Come on with it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Man, they shouldn't give him a goddamn dime. There's much shit going on in the world. I ain't looked in the news today. I can't even think, you know what? It's injustices, real injustices. You know what I mean? They put that bullshit out there so you don't even care about the real shit that's
going on
or it seem imaginary.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If I ain't telling you something about Lil Wayne or something like that, you half-ass want to listen.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And Facebook is the devil.
Hey.
It don't make it no better. You know what I'm saying?
What I just said yesterday?
The negativity wins.
I just said Facebook is the devil yesterday.
Yeah. Facebook is Walmart.
They manipulate our minds.
Yeah, that's why they put it out there.
That's news.
Hey, and you know what? When they put up that post, like, they going to be charging for Facebook, I'm like, yeah, right. You know how many police done busted people and all fans? Are you crazy?
Instagram.
I know, that's a lie. They ain't never making niggas pay for that.
Instagram worse than anything, because
Instagram more is a more of a picture thing.
Right.
It's supposed to be pictures with their money.
Right.
Make pictures with their cars.
Right. Everything.
That's an indictment. That's
building the case against themselves.
Right. Because they never stopped.
That's
what
this stuff was made for.
We got the greediest government in the world.
They came up with some smart stuff and they made it.
Exactly.
We got the greediest government in the world. They are not going to watch you get money. Like I tell my partners, the trap rappers. I'm like, some of them really still trapping. I'm like, bro. They on to you now because of your video or whatever.
And they ain't taking 8, 7 years, 5 years. They taking a couple months to come to get you because of everything you did on the net.
They have to let you accumulate. I said, now listen, do you think they going to let you go from the street stunting and talking all that shit to go to the industry and make millions? You think they finna let you? You know what? Classic case, Bobby Shmurda.
Right.
You think they finna just let you dance your way up into millions? They like, no, nigga, no. These niggas doing that shit for real.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And they rapping about it.
Yeah, telling everything.
They can't take that.
I can see if you did it and got out of it and then rapped about it. Cause
right.
And they do it.
Right.
Right.
You done got signed, you done make this money, ain't no evidence.
Now like, see, look.
Rallo, he getting paper right now. He did his thing. He got his paper. You can't mess with him.
Right.
He got his paper now.
Dog got a lot of money.
Yeah.
That was that hair
you can't even
that was a lot of money.
Really out of a world
said, hood. Rallo ain't sold three CDs. And he got plenty of money. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. See, man, remember Meechum? That what took Meechum them down. You know what I'm saying? They had too much money. They was putting it out there.
He was running a real business. He wasn't trying to get out.
Right.
He kept going. He wasn't trying to build a business. He kept running it like, man, this is my life. This is all he knew. That's
you know
all
what?
Knew.
It's hard to pull cash out. Because I'm like that with a couple cash where I'm like, dog, make the transition.
Right.
Come over here. You can get money. Right. I can show you how to get money. You know what I'm saying? And you can still live the lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? And get the money. They like, you know, I am. You know, look. To next week, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Then next week is next week. Yeah. Then next week is next week. You know what I'm saying? Oh, man, just can't leave. Right. And here come the people.
Yep, here come the people.
Then you sitting there like, damn, I wish I'd have got out. You know what I'm saying? It's too late. Right. They never listen. You know what I'm saying? Nobody never listen. And you have to show people. You know what I mean?
Right.
This is a visual. That's why we were talking about the artists always put out a video because we people are visual. If they can't see it, if I show you, that's what I did. I said, I was telling these cats something. I said, you know what? I'm going to show them. I'm going to do it.
Right.
I'm going to this bank and I'm going to do this. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to do it. And I was bringing it all back to them like, fam, I'm doing it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
This is a radio.
Radio show. Podcast, you know what I'm saying, but it's all good. The Gotti Show, you know what I'm saying. Now we got Miss K on. I don't know if I'm trying to talk her into being on. I need something good to look at when people they ain't gonna want to look at. You know what I'm saying? And somebody to, I could fall back.
Yeah.
I could tweet you the link. Yeah, and we on Facebook Live. You know what I'm saying?
Tell them this
Lil
Greg, you know.
Shout out to Lil Greg.
Lil Greg.
Y'all know they know me, you know.
Let me see. He got my phone. I was going to say, I'll tweet you the link. You know what I'm saying? We here every Thursday.
Yeah, you know I come here every Thursday.
I see you.
She just started coming.
Yeah.
Right. Right. I'm going to try to talk her into coming on in here. You know what I'm saying?
We're going to get it cracking now, you know.
We got.
You know what I'm saying? He said, yeah. I'm going to slap you on my page and everything.
Right.
We're gonna get this big.
Yeah, because that's what it's about, man. Communicating with the community, you know what I'm saying, and letting them know they can speak and you know what I'm saying, and get in. And if you got issues, especially if you got issues, man, use the platform, get it out. You know what I'm saying? Like I got jerked over today. You know what I'm saying?
You both
jerked over. I'm gonna tell you, like I tell all. The young people do not get caught up in this system, especially in Wisconsin.
Right.
They will rake your ass over the coals. You know what I'm saying?
This is cheese town.
Yeah.
This is a cheese town. We wrapped around farms. This ain't, we the only probably is right. You got this, Wisconsin, and you got, Madison, and you got probably Racine, the only hood.
Right.
We wrapped around farms, man.
Yeah.
It's a woman in a white state.
Right. And that's why I told her. We in a hick ass town. Yeah. And you don't even realize it because you stay around all blacks, but we in a hick ass town.
I go this is the country. And stuff. I go out to Appleton and all these farms. And we wrapped around farms.
Right.
Tornadoes and all this. Man, we ain't made them. This, we really, our parents, I think our parents, you know, our ancestors got us here to get us out of the way. But they fall back down on us. Here.
Now, let me tell you. That's what I was going to say. Let me tell you. I'm 42. Right. You know what I'm saying? I can remember this month being nice. You know why everybody came here? The welfare and all that, because they used to give you a check for each kid that you had.
Right.
Plus food stamp, Big Rob in Milan. They used to give it all to you. Get Big Rob on there. Come on, Big Rob. Big Rob know better than anything. Tell him,
I've been 40-something years.
See? Now tell them, Milwaukee used to be halfway decent.
Milwaukee was a great city. Yeah. Back in 1980, when I got in 82, it was real. They had just started the new freeway.
Right.
Right. They were building on the freeway there. That's when the freeway was just getting built.
Right.
And it was really, really nice back then. You know, dime a dozen.
Yeah.
You know?
See? I think it got bad when...
crack?
It got real bad when...
Crack?
It got real... Yep.
Crack.
When got,
you know who I blame?
From me being a younger.
Yeah, all them Gary in Chicago motherfuckers start running here.
I grew up good, right. You know, here. Right. When New Orleans, when that stuff happened in New Orleans, that's when it got bad.
Hey,
I'm not even gonna lie to y'all because, dude, like our parents say, we was able to ride our bikes to the lake. We was able to do that stuff a little bit, but it got real bad
when
we was younger. I'm 25.
Oh man!
So when I was 17, 16,
it was bad when you was little. Yeah,
it was bad, but it wasn't.
What year you was born?
91.
Man, I was selling major crack cocaine. I was selling big crack cocaine in 91, man.
You know, I'm telling you, it's the city bad right now, man.
Yeah, he right though. He right though. It wasn't that bad. He right.
Traffic and kicking and all that. Go to the lake.
Right.
Man, I just came from the lake, dude. Ain't nobody at the lake. We used to, after when it 6 o'clock hit and the sun was going down, everybody at the lake, we in traffic, really? We kicking it.
Kicking it.
Right.
Ain't no more kicking it. Niggas dying every day. Ain't nobody dying once in a while. Everybody dying. Niggas dying every day.
Right. Right.
You gotta keep your family close to you.
Yeah, you right, because I was going to say in 91, shit, I was, man, out here terror. It was plenty crack. I blame crack.
It was definitely NWA. Crack.
Hey, come up close up. Come up close. We got Say Gun in here. I blame crack and NWA. When NWA came, niggas start, man, before you know it, niggas had Jerry Curls, Raider caps, and AK-47s. You know what I'm saying? And then they had crack. Too. Throw the crack in there, and then... You got niggas going wild.
That's right. Y'all niggas was fighting. We got the shooting when.
We were shooting.
Y'all was fighting, though. In 91,
I got shot in both my legs. They shot my partner. We was shooting. See, we was gangbanging.
Right.
It was the folks and the peoples and all that. Yeah. See, we was gangbanging. You know what I'm saying? So it was a lot of shooting and robbing niggas for coats and shit like that. You get a starter coat. You better not. Yeah, your Georgia, you started coke, man. Don't have on both.
Right.
You was going home in your socks, homie. You was going home in your socks. They was jumping out the cars. That's what they did. So you ain't had no way to. You know what I'm saying?
Niggas,
it was wild.
But it was structure out here.
Right. Because the games,
and stuff.
And like Chicago.
Like now, it's just motherfucker. It's just free for all. Now.
It's just free for all.
No structure, nowhere.
They got that CCW.
They took all the OGs out. They locked them all up and they killed them all. And the ones they didn't kill, they gave good jobs. You know what I'm saying? Niggas said, man, fuck that. You know what I'm saying? And got loose. They left them out here, no knowledge. You know what I'm saying? They didn't tell them nothing. So they ran wild. Like in Chicago, I watched the documentary. Man, them little young dudes was like, man, them old niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, they trying to, they like, we wild now. It's too late. You know what I'm saying? We out here. They was like, man, they put them cameras up here.
You're cracking right now, dude.
Yeah, we got Mars Lightning in the building. Yeah.
Let me go get dressed then.
We got Mars Lightyear. We got my partner Saint Gunner. This is my partner right there, man. Yeah. Yeah. Hot music coming from these cats. You know what I'm saying? Live on the Gotti Show. Hashtag the Gotti Show. Mars, they came in with you? Ooh, man, I say you roll like that. How y'all doing? I ain't know nothing. I ain't being rude. I'm just saying y'all fine. That's it. You know what I'm saying? We on Facebook Live. We on Spreaker.com Live. Follow me. Look. Give Miss K, you give them your info.
What?
So yeah. Where they can follow us and all that.
You can't do
all that. Right, right. It's going down in the snow. You know what I'm saying? Real life. Yeah. I thought they rolled in with Mars. I said, man, I'm finna start back rapping. You know what I'm saying? So I'm finna start back rapping and shit, man. They come in like that. You know what I'm saying? What's going on with y'all brothers, man?
Hello? Huh?
Just that Mars. What's happening?
Okay, here.
The videos.
Yeah,
yeah.
Let's go catch this couple dollars. That's get up with you next Thursday.
Yeah. Okay, for sure, man. For sure. Okay. Thanks for coming through, man. Thank y'all, man. All
like
right,
I
look,
said,
man.
I just came from the lake. Check, I might check. Have my sandals on. You know, I just came out the water.
Yeah, it's all good.
I don't wear sandals with no socks, you feel me?
Right. That's why I told my son, you never know when you got to get down. You know what I'm saying? He used to wear his, I'm like.
I used to buy the Nike boots.
The Nike boots? Yeah.
They got to be Nike boots.
Let's get that grip.
Be the bitch
boots. You had some special boots.
Yeah.
Women. Special boots. Vaseline. Right. Right, I remember back, you get ready to fight a motherfucker, you try to take everything off and shit. You know what I'm
put
saying? Try to take your shirt off and shit. Don't take your shirt off, bro. Soon as it get right here, I'm on you. Man, you going to be like, dog, it's way over there, though. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I move when I want to, goddammit.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't got to. I talk slow and all that, but... whoop ass fast, you know what I'm saying? Don't try it. Don't come down here tripping. You know what I'm saying? I'm fully prepared. Anyways, though, we got Saint, we got Mars, we got Miss K. We was talking about R. Kelly. We probably moved because once I started to talk about the R. Kelly thing, I realized it wasn't really nothing to talk about. You know what I'm saying?
Like, about it.
I don't know, man. Hey, Hugh Hefner got his own crib.
Right. That's what we said.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't really know too much about
that
shit.
The same shit Hugh Hefner did, he doing.
Yeah, he got some girls in the house, and they trying to say, I'm sorry, I don't mean to be talking over.
Exactly.
They ain't even hold him out yet. Nobody stepped up and say, you know what I'm saying? Nothing like that. He just got him in the house.
A girl said she might be in the hostage
zone. Right. They tried to say,
brainwashed.
I was watching TMZ today, and first, just let me say, I hate TMZ. You know what I'm saying? I fucks with them on the news tip and all that, but they personal opinions I could do without. You know what I'm saying? But they probably saying that about me. They don't know about it. Anyways, they was like, he was abusive. See how y'all just like waiting for the rest?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's how I was too. Like, okay, abusive how? That's just it. That's what they do to you. You're abusive. White women. Man, oh, did y'all hear about Kevin Hart?
Oh, yeah.
I forgot all about Kevin Hart.
He got caught cheating.
Ooh, hey, I heard about it on the radio, right? You would have thought that woman... that he cheated on her. The chick that was the DJ chick?
Yeah.
Man, she was just like, this is what happened. He got a pregnant wife or whatever, and he was in the back seat with some other chick. And, I guess cozying up, as, you know, they say and shit. Whatever the fuck, you know, that is and shit. Who knows? You rich. Rich people kiss each other and all kind of shit. You know, get a little head, you know what I'm saying? What's a little head between two friends? You know what I'm saying? I mean, and she like, he's cheating. She was like, we don't know what the pictures could mean, but we do know she just claimed it. Like,
you
he
know
cheating.
What? It's rare you find somebody that's, I think dealing with a man with that much money, a millionaire period, he bound to have multiple women. Honestly.
Come on now. Come on now. Why don't y'all just give in? See, America's so uptight. it wouldn't be so much cheating if you let people have 5-6 wives. You know what I'm saying? Everybody could get a position. You know what I'm saying? Why we got to be fighting and all that? You know what I'm saying? Why we got to be arguing and shit? Come on, join up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, what's wrong with that? Then it wouldn't be, you got to sneak around and all that. You know what I mean? That's bullshit, man. It's just too much confusion. Come on in here. You join up. This your room. Here your toothbrush and your uniform. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Anyway, what's going on, brother?
Hello.
Yeah. We up in here, man. What is it, about 8:44? We got about 15 minutes left. I don't know. I'm going to tell you one thing, even from Tiger. Like, for some reason, white women.
Tiger and Kylie, they still young as fuck anyway.
Dude look like he 12 still. Right. You know what I'm saying? He look like a little kid.
They should be going
right. Like, yeah, when they together, I'm like, what's the big deal? They like he look like me and shit. You know what I'm saying? With this shit. Dog look like a kid. I'd be like, you know what, they rich. You can't keep up. If your kid is rich, bro, and you letting your kid be rich, like I would be, I'm sorry, I'm going to be like white folks when I get rich. I'm going to come bail my kids out and all that type of shit that they do. Because let me tell y'all one thing. I've been to prison. And you know what you see a lot of? White guy in there could be 50. And his parents still come to see him. You know what I'm saying? Still put money on this book. We've been taught to cut yours off.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, he in jail. Turn him in and cut him off. That ain't nothing but some slave shit.
Swear to God.
Think about it. That ain't nothing but some slave shit.
It was a conversation on Facebook about how the black family is pretty much the only family they believe in putting their child out at 18 versus other race. Will let their child stay and grow, go through their mishaps and all that shit.
Yep.
But the black family, you 18, you got a motherfucker. You
right.
Or it might be before 18.
Yep. You
I was
right.
In high school when I was
out. See?
Right.
And that's what your parents would take. That's the whole thought process in the black. When you 18, you gone. You know what I'm saying? You grown. I ain't got to deal with you no more. You're out.
And they don't even be fully grown. Some of them don't.
When you're 8, now that you older, don't you realize? I think of my 18-year-old self. Like I say, some of y'all kids, when y'all get older, you're going to be like, I was dumb as a motherfucker.
Man.
You wasn't dumb. You just made a lot of dumb decisions and did a lot of dumb shit.
You was just unaware.
Right. And you need to listen. Because some people be telling you. I got older, and I could think of everything that everybody told me when I was going through. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, my fam told me. You know what I'm saying? Or my mama tried to tell me. You know what I'm saying? When you 20 and shit, like, come on, man. Nobody tell you nothing about life. When you 20, think when you 18, bro, that day before that, you was just 17.
Right.
What the fuck made you grow up so much overnight? You know what I'm saying?
Like,
what happened? You know what I'm saying? Man, I mean, what gave you all of a sudden so much game and shit? You know what I'm saying? All you could do is buy cigarettes and get into R-rated movies.
Right.
That is about it. You know what I'm saying? When you turn 18, that's about the length of it. You know what I'm saying? You can't do shit else. Hey, you know what I'm saying?
We really need to get out of what we accustomed to. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Right.
Whoopings, all that type of shit. God, whooping is not some slave shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? Just think of how is it not, bro? Right. Right. Why is you whooping me? This shit should be illegal. You know what I'm saying?
It actually is, though.
But you grow up on it. Now listen. People tell me, did y'all get whoopings growing up? Now think about it. Think about it. If whoopings worked, you wouldn't have to keep doing them.
That shit didn't work.
I was in prison. I told a guy when I got out, because I was just getting clear. So I was like, when I get out, man, I'm not hitting my kids. I'm not doing that shit no more, man. Mm-hmm. No more whoopings. And I didn't. You know what I'm saying? No more whoopings and none of that shit. Fuck that shit.
Right.
He was like, man, whoopings. Everybody got whoopings. Whoopings is this. I got whoopings. I said, nigga, we in prison.
You,
we in prison, fam.
I told my mother, The last time I got a whooping, I think I was like 15. My grandfather told my mother, like, what's wrong with just sitting down and talking to her and coming to an understanding?
Right.
Instead of getting a belt and wearing yourself out trying to chase her around. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Because I gave my mama hell when I was a shorty.
Right.
But it's just like, that shit don't work.
Man, that's like I got a 4-year old. Everybody want to whoop him. I'm like, I like to think that I can outsmart a 4-year old. That I got enough brains to, like you say, sit fam down and right. You know, because if I hit him, you know, well, I want y'all to think about that. That's some bullshit. A motherfucker you love and depend on and everything just take off and hit you one day. That got the fuck a motherfucker up, man. That probably did something to you that you don't even recognize.
Right.
Because people have shit deep down, you know what I'm saying? You probably away because of that. I can remember the last time when I said nobody will ever put their hands on me ever again without getting retaliated on. I was going to school and I was like 12. I don't know what I had did, bro. I don't know what had happened. But my mama slapped me in my face like I was a nigga off the street. You know what I'm saying? And that clicked, so I was like, and that's how I got shot the last time, too. I could have just let niggas hold me.
Right.
But I had that in me to never let nobody hit me. So it wasn't no tough. I wasn't like, it just was a reaction.
Right.
And he shot me a bunch of times. You know what I'm saying? But it happens. Yeah. But that's what happened. So, mama, you got me shot. Because you put it in me to never let nobody touch. Make sure you give me a copy of put the camera over there. Put the camera over there. I ain't gonna come in here and take over my show.
Really? Me?
Yeah.
I got a lot going on. I don't know, not too much, but you know, I got a few things in the works. Right now, I got this project I'm working on called Conscious Rockstar.
Okay.
It's a little insight on it. You know, me, I do, you know, conscious music. You know, and I like to, all my music is based off feeling. You know, so I like to give people an insight of what I'm going through. And it's like, you know, people look at my shows and stuff, they'll be like, oh, yeah, you turned up, you just doing all this. Some people, you know, but all my stuff is based off feeling. So when I do perform, all that stuff I'm saying,
you can feel it.
It's coming out.
Because I watched you perform.
It's all coming out. So people, it's more than just jumping around or just, you know, just yelling. I, you know, I like to have people understand what I'm saying. You know,
right.
Everything I say is a, you know, it's a message. I don't like to waste no bar.
Right.
Everything, you know what I'm saying? So it's like bar for bar. You know, I try to send a message for everybody and still, you know, give people something not to hear to.
Right.
You know, because a lot of time that lyrical music can get a little saturated. When you put that new school, you know, that now, that here now, but what they doing, you know, now.
You got him?
What you doing, you know, people are like, oh, man, hey, okay. You hear what he said?
Right.
You know, so that's what I try to do. Keep it real.
Yeah, I like that music. It's dope.
Appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Hey, how long you been doing this?
13 years. No, this is 14 years. This year is 14 years straight.
Yeah?
I took off about, I could say, 2 months, 3 months, you know, but as far as doing music and actually continually write, record, stuff like that, like 14 years.
That's cool.
Now, look, do you, excuse me, y'all, my mic died. Do you feel like doing the type of music that you do that is harder, you know, to do your thing, you know what I mean? Because everybody want to hear, look, what I call hat cat rap. Hat cat rap. But you know what? Answer the question, then I want to tell you. Answer.
Yeah, it is hard, man. I mean, see, at first it was real hard, you know, because I only been walking for, 6 years now, you know, from Chicago. So
okay.
It was hard because all the type of music people was doing, you know, I had to try to blend in. So that's why I started, you know, to not go away from my lane.
Right.
I try to keep my conscious style as well as do that, you know, up tempo and ride the beat as well like that. You know,
right.
But it's real hard because everybody's doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Right.
You know, and it's like, I really don't, I just be on the sideline looking in and, you know, just continue to do my thing. But it's like, everybody is trying to go the same route.
See y'all later.
So I kinda, you know,
you too.
I'm trying to part to see like Moses, you know, saying just make a way from, you know, certain rappers might be, because it is a lot of hidden gems and all.
Right.
You know.
Right.
So, but it's just that we just gotta. I feel it's all about marketing. You know, it's gotta be marketing.
Yeah. And finding your fan base, you know, yeah, what I'm saying? And
that's the major key right there.
And that's what a lot of these artists ain't doing. They making music for everybody, but everybody don't want to hear your shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And that don't mean you not go pop. That just mean that this is one person that might say, you know what I mean? But you know what? I had a formula for guys that's like more conscious and whatever because of the type of music that everybody used to and clutching to. You know, it's all dumbed down. So I say, shit, get you a dope-ass trap beat. Get you a hook, a catchy hook. Hat, cat, rap. Hat, cat, rap. Hat, cat, rap. You know what I'm saying? And then drop straight bars. You know what I'm saying?
I was thinking about, rap. Hey, it's crazy because I was thinking about that for a long time.
Right. You know who used to do that? X-Clan. Remember X-Clan?
Yeah.
They used to have them funky-ass beats, and they was dropping straight knowledge. You know what I'm saying? Straight knowledge. But you was too caught up in the... You hear X-Clan in the club. You know what I'm saying? You was too caught up in the music. And you singing it. Don't even know you singing knowledge. You done fooled niggas.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Straight up. You done fooled them into thinking.
Nowadays, more people concerned about hooks than actual... Yeah. Concerned, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Catchy hooks.
You still got some people out there, though, that really listen to what you're saying. Like, I'm one of them type of people. I love storytellers, and somebody got something to talk about. I don't want to hear all day, I'm riding around with my bitch, and I'm but like, I don't want to hear that shit every day.
That's
and all that.
This new rap is ADH, what is it? ADD. Yeah. That's they all over the place.
Yeah.
I used to, you know, I'm from the old school where you wrote a verse and you stuck to the title of the song.
Exactly.
If the song was called Riding the Bike, that's what your verse was about.
Yeah.
Now, the song could be called Riding the Bike and the nigga talking about choppers and like, what? And all he got to do is mention bike once and that's it. You know what I'm saying?
See, that started because a lot of these rappers, I'm going to tell you like this, being a rapper, a lot of these rappers are lazy. So when they get in the studio and they see all the other guys smoking and chilling, they don't really want to take time to sit down and write that verse.
Right.
So they'd be like too geeked up, you know what I'm saying? So they feel like, okay, I'm going to just go in the booth and spit this.
Right.
You know, and then why you get them? Yeah, because they can't think of nothing else.
Right.
So that's their pickup.
That's where mumble rap came from, too, I think.
Because they started freestyling, and then they kept thinking that one was freestyling.
Right.
So,
catch the baby. Yeah, everybody do that. So it just went into that. They like, fighting, better have words no more.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Shit. And people go by it.
Yeah.
The dumber it is, the catchier it is, they own it. While real artists is like, you know, but like you said, marketing. You can put that shit out there.
Yeah.
Like one person I think about, and then we gotta wrap it up, y'all, Future. They talk about Future and what he talk about, but he found his fan base.
Yeah.
Drug addicts.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He found his fan base. So fuck whoever else buy it. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
Because if I could get 2-3 million motherfuckers and even more to stream it, then fuck y'all. I don't have to make nothing else but Papa Molly. Right. Papa Molly, right. Papa Perk. He sound like he don't.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Like
you mix all that shit, nigga, you be dead.
You fucking out here walking zombies.
Future 100 pounds wet. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no way. I mean, he's a thin brother. Ain't no way he taking all them drugs and still living. You know what I'm saying? And then he get, you know, and you know, another clue is he get too much work done.
Right.
There's no way you can do that much work. Dog put out 2-3 projects 1 year. Wasn't it 3 or 4? Wasn't it something like that?
Yeah.
You don't get that kind of work done high all the time. Oh, all downers?
Well, I ain't gonna. Gucci was able to do that shit.
It was something. See,
he's a big nigga.
Let me tell y'all something.
He's gonna blow 2 hours.
Thank, because like, they,
come on.
They leave out a drug, especially when they talk about sipping lean. If I smoke weed and sip lean, I'm going to sleep. But if I'm high off some blow or something, and I sip lean, I'm in the middle. I can still move around. I'm a little high.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm high, the motherfucker, but I can still, okay, yeah, this is that and this is that. You know what I'm saying? I'm maintaining. I got some shades on. You know what I'm saying? You don't know what's happening behind them shades. Don't take them off, though, because then the cat out the bag, then, like, oh, hell, no, look at them. You know what I'm saying? But as long as them shades on, I got the little lean. That's why we used to see Lil Wayne and Justin Bieber and them. Remember, dog, them came down with, who was that fighting? They had Floyd, they had no shirts on and shit.
Right.
Come on, I was in the 90s. That when you get high, you get hot.
Yep.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got, and you don't care. You coming up, I take this shit off. You know what I'm saying? Come on now, we looking right at them. Hey, right. Another thing, flu-like symptoms.
Oh, yeah.
One time, my daddy had got a settlement. He gave me $7,000.
Mm-hmm.
I was up for 5 days. At the end of the 5 days, guess what I had? Flu-like symptoms. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's what that come from. Stand up. And then how can you stay up all them nights?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. All these rappers, y'all not listening to these niggas. They telling, they, like I said, they leaving out a drug. Ain't no way you could pop a perk, smoke some weed, and sip some lean. And then they got these young niggas doing it. And then they ain't no good. Like, dog, quit listening to them. They lying. They leaving out the coke, nigga, or the meth, or whatever. They leaving out that upper.
Yeah.
It got to be an upper, bro. You can't take all. Why would you want to? I don't want to be. You know what I mean? Man, you gotta. That's why what Future say. See, he talked that shit real good when he say he on Pluto and he on Mars at the same damn time. These niggas wasn't paying attention. You know what I'm saying? He telling you, I'm here and I'm there. How you here and you there? It's two different things going on.
Yeah.
I'm off this and I'm off that at the same time. You know what I'm saying? Right. It's going down. You know what I'm saying? They don't let them fool y'all, man. They doing extra drugs. They leaving out a drug. Don't try to copy them and die. You know what I'm saying? Niggas be dying and shit. Smoking K2. I say,
man, that K2.
If you, that shit is like, you might as well go and get you a crack rock. If you go smoke K2.
Man,
if you got to get high that bad, where you will smoke some shit that say not for human consumption, right on the thing, then go get you a crack rock. It'll be out of your system in about 2-3 days.
Exactly.
You got to get high that bad. Start smoking crack. You know what I'm saying?
Daily life.
Yeah.
My guy got in the car and rolled some of that. And I said, man, you got to get up out of here with that shit.
Man, listen,
he fired up trying to pass. His blood was this big. He had a huge blood of that shit. I knew it wasn't real then. Don't nobody roll a blood that damn big.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, what is it? What the fuck is that? Yeah, that's some bullshit in there, ain't it? You know, man. Saint, what's going down, man?
Shit, man. I'm gonna drop a video next week.
Well,
I'm gonna drop a shooting video next week.
Yeah. Which one? Big Bag. I'm about to pull up in the spot with a Big Bag when I first heard that. I got the Mars. You on Spotify? Okay, we got to get you there because Shane is, let y'all know, Shane is in my Spotify list. It, don't everybody just get in that. That's my ride list. Cause I'm telling you, I like to ride like this.
Right.
That's where I'm at with mine. You, I don't want to be lame. You know what I'm saying? I like my heart to beat fast. You know what I'm saying? I like my shit to go hard. You know what I'm talking about? So, let's go and finish telling us.
Yeah, we're shooting that Big Bag video next week. In the current
situation, that's already iTunes,
Spotify,
Cinderella,
all that shit.
Yeah.
Volume 2, that's on the way. That's in the works right now.
I got to get on that, man.
Yeah,
I want to get on some stuff with Mars, too. I want to do some different. I like to go outside the box. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You got to, man. You got to. You know, man, I went to school with white folks. I was like, man, this motherfucker's living around this motherfucker.
Yeah. See, that's the only way I am because I grew up around Hispanics.
Hispanics, so, yeah.
Mexicans and Puerto Rican.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So moving to Milwaukee is like just to a different environment.
Right.
Right.
So it's like, you know, I fit in, but don't fit in.
Right.
Stand out, but I, you know.
Not Chicago.
I grew up around a lot of white people, hood people. I traveled a lot as a shorty. I traveled a lot as a shorty because my father was in the Navy.
Oh, yeah. Navy so, brat.
Here, we got here, shit, we was in the hood. On 16th and Locust.
Oh, yeah. That's the hood.
With all the vice lords.
Yeah.
So,
that's one of them places you didn't go if you wasn't from there.
On the real.
They ain't just pop up down there talking about, where, y'all seen Karen? Yeah, where Karen house?
For real.
You be running up. It was certain places. Let me tell you one funny story. We're going to get up out of here, man. Back in the day, like I say, we used to gang bang here and shit, right? I had got drunk. I used to get really drunk. You know what I'm saying? I had got drunk, and we was at that store right there on First and Keith.
Oh, yeah.
So my drunk ass decided to turn my hat to the right and go into the store. So when I walk into the store, look, even old ladies is looking at me like,
the fuck you doing?
Niggas, you lost your mind. Look, remember I told you I was drunk, right? So I'm in there drunk in line and shit. Everybody looking at me. So I'm starting to feel a little nervous now. You know what I'm saying? The dude behind the counter, like, you know, like, he hurrying up, like, to get me out of there. Like, you better hurry up. Get out. When I went outside, it was about 40 of them little motherfuckers out there.
Man.
I was like, they like, hey, man, you gotta turn your hat.
Yeah.
Now, I'm with my cousin, right? My cousin know all of them. She a girl. She like, chill out, y'all. This is my cousin. They like, he got to turn that hat. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, you know, Big Rob, back in the day, you know, you don't turn no hat.
Right.
If anything, you take it off.
Yep.
You turn it, your ass get beat. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, man, I ain't turning my hat. He snapped. Like, this nigga. Well, I'm like, oh, but look, hey. Like, remember I told you I was drunk. I sobered up like a motherfucker. I was backing up the whole time. They was talking to my cousin. I went from the stand around waiting for what happened. I backed up all the way to the car. Got in the seat. I told my cousin, hit it. He like, what the hell was you thinking? I'm like,
man.
I don't know, but we need to go to the store again because I'm sober. I'm so, what no way I was gonna win that fight. It was, you know what I'm saying? What no way out of that. It was an ass whooping. I'm sorry. I just gotta keep it real. I couldn't even tell you the story. Like, yeah, I was hitting the cup. Nah, it was, but I ain't lying when I said, maybe it wasn't 40, but it was at least 20. You know what I'm saying?
What
no, out of nowhere. Like they had walkie talkies. Like, oh, there's a nigga in the store.
They call.
Yeah. They came.
Chicago, though, but Chicago was like colored.
Exactly.
You wear red and blue in the
neighborhood.
You
getting
your ass.
Yeah.
See. It was when I moved from Milwaukee in 1989 to Chicago. Same issue with you. I had my hat cocked. I was left. Everything was to the left.
Right.
So Mexican was like, hey, you gotta break your hat off. I'm like, you gotta change that hat. I didn't know what the hell they were talking about. I was young.
Right.
I'm like, what? Turn my hat.
I'm
like, you make me turn my hat. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They had to sit me down. I was about, you know, they had to sit me down. Like, look,
right.
Hang out here. You know, this is.
Right.
You know, but I am. That's how it was. But, you know, it was bad. I think it's still bad.
That was, then that South Side was wild. Because one thing I know about the South Side here, and I be telling cats, like, oh, niggas didn't used to be over there like that. You could, niggas didn't used to be over there.
Kings had this shit sold up.
Thank you, that's what I said. Nigga, the feds had to come get them.
Yeah.
They was doing real life crime, extorting businesses, all that.
Yeah.
Killing people, they was doing real life crime, dog.
Man,
the feds had to come get them. What if the feds would have came got them? No, I say it didn't used to be. Niggas just didn't used to be on the north side walking to the cornerstone and shit like that. Man, they'll roll up like that. They'll roll up out of nowhere like, hey, you lost? You know what I'm saying? You got to be. They over there now chilling. West Dallas too. Niggas just didn't go up there.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And it's just, you couldn't just go to West Allis. I went to school in West Allis in 1988. It was racist in the...
Man.
We had... It was... Literally, it was only enough of us to fit on the little short bus.
Damn.
And everybody had their own seat. You know what I'm saying? That's how many of us went to that school, man. So, I had some experience, especially 8th grade. We got to go, y'all. But 7th grade, I was trying to get along. During that summer break, I discovered the Nation of Islam and Public Enemy. So, 8th grade was, you know what I'm saying, was on some whole other shit. You know what I'm saying? They was like, what the? Deshaun, what happened? Like, yeah, you a devil, motherfucker. I know what's up with you.
I came back from summer break.
Devil, yeah. I came back from woke like a motherfucker.
Stay woke.
Man, let us get up out of here, man. I appreciate y'all coming through, man.
Thank y'all for tuning in.
Man, appreciate Miss K for being here. Add some prettiness to the show. You got to look at me. I know they be like, oh, Lord Jesus. I wish he'd get a girl up in there. My fault, y'all. I'm tripping. Saint, Big Rob, Mars, Lightyear. Check out their music. Give me y'all Instagram and stuff right quick, man, where they can find your music.
Mars Lightyear, man. Facebook, just Google. Go to Google, make it easy. Go to Google, type in MARZ.
And everything is Saint Gutta, SAYNT. Pretty sure everybody knows how to spell it.
Yeah, Saint Gutter, GUTTA. They'll be looking for Saint Gutter.
Saint Gutter, Mars. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you Google it, and Miss K. And we're out.
We out of here. All right,